If your industrial development kit LCD, known as IDK LCD, is failing to boot on your AM5718 or AM5728 IDK evaluation module and you want to learn how to fix it, then you're watching the right video. In this video, I will cover two possible causes for the failure of the LCD to boot and demonstrate how to fix them. The first possible cause is incorrect touch and LCD cable connections between the LCD kit and the IDK board. In this video, we will walk through the steps to properly connect both ends of the LCD and touch cables to the IDK EVM. If you are using AM5718 board and have properly connected these cables, but the LCD kit is still failing to boot, then the likely cause is that the AM5718 IDK board has not been set to LCD mode. We will learn how to set the IDK board to LCD mode. I will be using AM5718 IDK board to show the correct way of connecting the touch and LCD cables. If you are working with the AM5728 IDK EVM, the steps shown are identical for the AM5728 board. These are two ribbon cables that were included with your LCD kit. The smaller cable is touch cable and the larger one is the LCD cable. We are going to connect the cables in the sequence shown here. Let's begin by connecting the touch cable end shown here to the IDK board. Flip the IDK board over to find the J17 connector shown here. Slide the black portion out to place the connector in the open position. Insert the plain end of the touch cable into the connector with the contact facing away from the IDK. Close the connector to secure the connection. Next, connect the LCD cable end shown to the LCD panel. Find the LCD connector on the LCD panel as shown here. Lift up the white flap of the LCD connector on the LCD panel. Insert the LCD cable into the black side of the connector as shown. Be sure that the cable contact is facing down towards the LCD panel. Once the cable is fully inserted, push the white flap down to secure the connection. Now, let's connect the other end of the LCD cable to the IDK board. Locate the J16 connector on the IDK board as shown here. Open the J16 connector by raising the black flap. Next, position the IDK board next to the LCD screen and connect the LCD cable to the J16 connector. The cable must be connected with the contacts facing away from the IDK board. Press down the black flap and secure the connection. Now, mount the IDK board onto the LCD screen. The screws on the LCD assembly fit through the holes on the PCB. Attach standoffs to secure the hardware. The last step is to connect the remaining touch cable end to the IDK board assembly. Locate the touch connector on the LCD board as shown. Open the connector by lifting up the back flap. Connect the touch cable to the LCD screen connector. Close the black flap to secure the connection. Prior to powering on the board, be sure to insert the micro SD card with the SDK flashed on it. Press the power on button. The LCD panel boots up and the Matrix application launcher appears on the LCD screen. Touch one of the icons. I am touching 3D icon here and run the Chameleon Man demonstration. This confirms that the touch screen is responding and the LCD is working properly. If you are using the AM5718 IDK and your board is still not booting up after making the proper touch and LCD connections, the likely cause is that the board is not in LCD mode. The AM5718 IDK is designed to operate in two modes. The mode is selected using a shunt on header J51. When the J51 shunt installed, the IDK operates in LCD and 4-port Ethernet mode. If the J51 shunt is not installed, it operates in 6-port mode and the LCD is disabled. For more details, refer to the AM571X IDK Quick Start Guide. Once the J51 shunt is installed, power up your board and the LCD should boot up properly. For more information about the AM5718 IDK and the LCD IDK kit, refer to the resources below. If this video has not resolved your LCD kit issues, please get in touch through the Sitara Processor Forum at the TI E2E community website as shown below. Thank you.